What is going on, everybody? Welcome to Robitech. So glad to have you guys here. All right, so let's talk about what we're putting inside of today's PC. Starting with the CPU, probably the best CPU in the 14th gen lineup, the Intel Core i7-14700K. Very excited about this. We're using the Live Mixer Z790. This is a beautiful build from ASRock. We got some little purple accents on it. So I was actually pretty excited about this. We spent a little money to make this look a little bit pretty. I mean, still the build's only 2200 bucks, which is actually a pretty good price. For RAM, we're gonna use some PNY, right? Which is always a lot of fun. The PNY XLR8, there are 32 gigs of 6000 mega transfer RAM. Some funny thing about PNY though, which is super interesting, is PNY actually started as a memory company. So they do make storage and they do make RAM. For our GPU, because we're using ASRock, and we're gonna use PNY, and the other thing too is that we'll be able to control the RAM with the same controller as this, so we're limiting the amount of RGB stuff. We can just install Polychrome, set the color, and forget it, and then actually remove it if we wanted to, and then we'll keep the basically the software, their Velocity X software on there, so we can do any overclocking or anything like that. Like PNY GPUs, our video on this, if you guys wanna learn more about it, is available. You can check that stuff out, and maybe we'll put a link down in the description, but really like these GPUs. For our power supply, God, nobody should be surprised. 850 watt, tough gaming. Love these power supplies. They're just very easy, very malleable cables. For our AIO, even though they just announced the new ones, they don't come out in October, we have the Kraken Elite 240 millimeter AIO. The thing that just about this case is that you can't do a 360 at the top. 14700K, especially if you do Intel stock settings, which is what we're gonna have set for this. 240 is gonna be fine. It's not gonna have quite the headroom, but it'll still be more than enough to cool it. Just to make sure we fill out the rest of the fan stuff and use their newer stuff, we're gonna use the F240 RGB Core, new fans from theirs. The H5 Flow Black. Yeah, it's really cool, right? The purple, that's why I like this. It's like a unique motherboard in and of itself. So the way this is gonna work, we're just gonna pop out the little side here, pull this open, it'll be fine. But yeah, we've already tested this, but yeah, that's the thing about, we use our CPUs a lot, our boards a lot. We've already tested this and we know it works, but there, it looks like there was a little thermal paste in one of the pins. Okay, so we're gonna pop that down. Get that out. Okay, here we go, guys. Pop this in like this, and let's see what happens. So what you're gonna do is you're just gonna make sure that this lines up. In this case, the sticker should be towards the CPU. But again, it just lines up with the little line in the center. And then you just take your fingers and give it a solid push. That was 102.4. 96, so both cases, we literally just crushed that. So there we go. Just gonna pop this in like this. So way we're gonna start here is from the back. There's a thumb screw right here. Just gonna pull that open and then it just slides right out. This just comes off very easily, just like that. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take your motherboard, just grabbing it like so. So here we go, taking everything like so, just basically setting it down, then grabbing it from the top and kind of slipping it down under. It goes in very easily. Just screw them in nicely. You do not want to strip the screw. So if it's not going in nicely, just go to the left a little bit, then go right. Keep wiggling it, and then eventually you'll get it to go in. Don't like force these screws. That's the one thing I always say, because then if you ever need to do maintenance, you're having to grab pliers to get panels off. I mean, to help like get the standoffs off and all that sort of stuff. It's just a whole pain. So like there, I got a little bit of a, there we go. So see now, so like that was a little bit harder. I pushed left and then went right a couple times until it caught and went in correctly. Man, people are really like passionate about pineapple and pizza. Who's a sardine on pizza person? Jimmy O, the build link, will good the whole thing, but I'll go through parts here in a minute so you guys can see the parts. Okay, there's nine places to install this, so you can see me doing it again down here. Okay, so sometimes it gets weird and then I just like switch screw holes. There we go. So there's 8 places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now this one actually has an extra standoff, which you can actually put in and install if you want to. It's just a support standoff. It's not necessary, but if you want to install the standoff to do that, you can. There we go. Got it. Do this one up here. Got that one in. There we go, that one's in. Okay, one more and then we'll have all of them in. How we doing likes on YouTube, guys? There we go. Perfect. Okay, so there's all of our screws in. Okay, so all of our screws are in. Oops, wow, that almost went off the edge. It almost sacrificed its life. Okay, so we got all of that in now. So what we're gonna do next is we're gonna start connecting all of our front panel connections. So that's what our next step is here. We're just gonna kind of take it and snap it right in there over this right here. Okay, just drop that down like that. It's actually pretty straightforward, whichever way you're gonna do it. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna open this up. So try to route these cables through already. Same thing with this one, route it, kind of take all the cables, kind of route them through. And the easy part is you just basically set this in the center. You're just gonna start in the bottom right-hand corner. Just start it. Bottom corner there. Just gonna grab our Asia horse extensions, which look like this. Ugh. Cable, gonna connect it right up there like that. So you can actually see it's actually connected in the closest one there. There we go. Let's get our GPU installed. Okay, here we go, opening it up. Ooh, so just go straight up and down. I like to look from the side here. It's really easy once it's kind of lined up. Let's give it a nice push. If it's not lined up, it won't go in very easily. Sometimes you have to, there it goes. And then sometimes you'll get a click, sometimes you won't. This one's kind of a little mushy. Just make sure it sits in nice and solid like that. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my cable and literally just plug it in just like that, and then push it as hard as you can. Just make sure it is all the way solidly in there. And then you're just gonna route your cable under and back over so it basically comes out of the bottom down here. So now what we're gonna do, guys, grab our 850 watt gold PSU. You're gonna see why I love these so much. Okay, so we're gonna pop this open. And these cables are why I love these cables so much. It's just so, so easy to work with. Okay, so what we're gonna do now, so we're gonna grab our 24 pin. It's gonna plug in right here and right here. Okay, there's that cable. We're gonna grab our SATA connection. It's gonna plug in right here. And then we're gonna grab our CPU connection, which is our CPU. They're easy. There's a 403. They only plug in one way, just like that. And then the last cable we need to plug in is this one right here, which is our cable running from our GPU. And that's gonna plug in right here. There we go. All of our cables are now plugged into our PSU, okay? Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put our fan up, which is different than what we normally do. Usually you don't have to do it the other way. So I'm just gonna set this nicely inside like this. It's gonna set right in there, just like that. And then you're gonna pop it up like so. Okay, so let's go ahead and get it all put back together here. So we're gonna put the front back on. There we go. Right back onto the top, just like that. Pops right on. And then boom, the build is complete, guys. There is our beautiful build, and we'll get it all purple and all that sort of stuff here in just a minute. Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. There we go. The lights are on. Temp is sitting at 33. That seems fine. Sitting at just at 32,266. No problem whatsoever. Temps wise, even on a 240 millimeter AIO, this thing is running no problem. But on a 240 millimeter, this isn't that surprising. It looks like it's gonna stay sub 90 though. And there we go. That is the build. Outside of it, guys, that is it for us today on Robitech Live. Thank you so much for everybody for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed the build. The build came out absolutely amazing. Have an amazing rest of your Intel Gamer Days, and we appreciate you guys, and we'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye, guys.